So for people that don't understand that rivalry, that Gophers North Dakota, to be a player in it, how intense was that rivalry?
Yeah, it's too bad. It's not quite what it used to be. I mean, they're not playing against each other. We used to play against those guys four times every year. You know, we hated them. They hated us. It was intense. I think it was at a great time in the rivalry too, because both teams had great teams. You know, I mean, the amount of talent they had on their roster, the amount of like first round picks in those games is just astronomical. So it's too bad it's not what it used to be. But at the time, yeah, that was the game. You know, you circle those games every year, and you could lose every game, but you beat those guys and you feel good.
So to have it be against North Dakota that night for the Final Five championship, what was the atmosphere like in there? I mean, how kind of electric was it?
As electric of a building as I've probably played in, you know, played in a game seven in Nashville last year. That's pretty crazy. Our home rink in Winnipeg in the playoffs is nuts too. And that building was right up there with those, yeah. You know, with those crowds. They had a lot of fans. It was St. Patrick's Day, so there was a little bit more green than we liked. you know, there was over 19,000 people slammed in here, and it was on fire.
What do you remember about the goal? I mean, kind of take us back through at that moment in the game. You're tied. You're in overtime, I believe, right?
Yep.
So what do you remember about, I mean, kind of your thought process through it?
I remember Jay Baribault getting it, and I think I hopped on the ice for a change. And if I remember, I think they turned it over kind of right inside our blue line. So they had a lot of guys going the wrong way. I was kind of going the other way. And, you know, I remember thinking, you know, if Jay could spring me, maybe I could beat my guy. Threw it a little bit behind me, so it was kind of a little bit of a race for the puck. And I remember right before I got to it, I think it was Brian Lee was the defenseman. He had his stick kind of in on me, so I couldn't really do much with it. But I remember peeking up and seeing Lamoureux. I don't know if he was initially going to play the puck or what he was thinking. But
he was caught, wasn't he?
He was kind of out. He was in the net, but he was like his back was like right on the post.
Yep.
So it was kind of a rolling puck, and I thought if I could just kind of throw it on net, you know, somewhere on the far side. You never know, right? It's just one of those things where more often than not, you're going to swing at it. It's going to go in the corner, get up, and just kind of get on a forecheck. I caught it clean.
You caught it clean. So what happened? So you caught the back of your blade and it popped up over?
Yeah, I just kind of swung my backhand at it, and I caught it right on the heel, and the puck was rolling, and it just went straight up in that upper corner. You know, if I do it 100 times, I'd probably do it 0 times. You know, it's just one of those things that happened at the right place, the right time.
And you're flying down the ice as fast as you can, so you go past the goal once you hit it. Did you know it was in immediately, or did it take a second?
I knew it was in. Like I said, you know, I kind of had out of the corner of my eye him out of the net. So when I hit it and I saw where it was headed, you know, I knew it was in. And I think he was pretty caught. You know, I think he was pretty surprised by it, so he didn't really move much. So by the time I was sliding by the net, I knew it was in.
You're a young kid at that point. You're a sophomore. It's a pretty big stage. What did that moment after feel like?
I was just so excited, you know, that we beat those guys.
Yeah.
You know, B, it was, you know, a big tournament, obviously, for our school, Final Five. I was just so happy for the team, you know, to make a play for my teammates. Mm-hmm. You know, that was a big game for our school, a big game for our group. And you know, by any means necessary, you want to win that game. You know, like I said, the rivalry is huge and the implications are huge. And so I was just so happy to kind of make an impact on a big game, you know, for my teammates.
I think you had a hat trick the night before, didn't you?
Yeah.
So does that play into, you know what, hey, I'm feeling good. I got the touch right now. I might as well just throw it at the net and see what happens. If you hadn't had kind of that scoring touch over the last couple, the game leading up to that, do you think you would have tried something different, or is that just in that scenario you're just going to see what happens?
Probably. You know, I was feeling good about my game at the time. I was playing pretty well. You know, you score a hat trick against Wisconsin the night before. You know, I think our line had scored a goal earlier in that game too. I think Ben Gordon scored a big goal to tie the game up. So our line was feeling good. We were playing well, and it's one of those things that, you know, when you're playing well, you're feeling good about your game, things just kind of happen. You know, you don't really think about it. Instincts kick in, and that was one of those times.
So you're hearing cheers, I'm guessing, and then are you also hearing some boos as you guys leave the ice?
That night?
Yeah.
No, it was too loud. That was a yeah. The North Dakota guys got drowned out that night.
They got drowned out that night. Does that ever come up? I mean, that's a pretty crazy goal. That, I mean, you search Blake Wheeler goal. I think that's the first thing that comes up.
Yeah, my kid. I mean, so my oldest son Louis is six. He's obviously old enough now, and you know he's been watching that one for a while. you know, he's got a lot of questions from him about that. Kind of the same types of questions, and so that's fun. You know, to show him some of the good memories, and you know, I'll BS with my teammates when we walk in here too, and you know, the young guys I'll. Yeah, you ever heard about that goal I scored here? And like, what? What are you talking? You know, because most guys are major, junior, and never played college. So they're what are you talking about? You played here before here? And it's like, so it's kind of an ongoing joke now. It's been going on for a little while, but yeah, we keep it alive.